Deadline Edition, July 8, 1947. The Army Air Forces has announced that a flying disc has been found and is now in the possession of the Army. Army officers say the missile, found sometime last week, has been inspected at Roswell, New Mexico, and sent to Wright Field, Ohio, for further inspection.
Welcome to episode 32 of Roswell Government Cover-Up. I'm Larry Bublitz.
And I'm Tennessee, Kentucky. Each episode, we talk about those events from July of 1947 and what the heck happened out there in New Mexico.
That's right, Tennessee. We focus only on actual government documents and nothing else. No crazy, wacky alien things. Just one item. Did something crash in New Mexico in 1947? And why has the government denied it for 60 years?
Those are all good questions. Tonight, we have some new deathbed confessionals, some audio archives, and anything else we can bring up with the Freedom of Information Act.
Yep, and since it's Thursday, it's time for our Witness Corner, where we play quotes from actual witnesses to the crash.
Did you say Thursday? Ah, crap, it's the wrong podcast. Oh.
Episode 81 of Star Wars Galaxies with Yivvits and Mr. Bubble. Today is Friday, August 31st, and while we're awaiting the many special treats of Chapter 7, I'm Mr. Bubble.
And I would be Yivvits.
You are Yivvits.
I am the Yivvits Wookiee.
Ah, here we are again.
Oh boy, yeah. 81.
I just like saying special treats. 81. 81 episodes takes
81
me back
is a special
to
treat.
1981.
No, hey, remember back in
but
the
really,
80s?
Where were you in 81? How old?
I would have been fairly young, I suppose. What was with our podcast scheduling? How did we get that messed
up? I know.
That was pretty bad.
My Hello Kitty PDA.
They're going to also know my alter ego.
Yeah, I know.
Which I didn't want anybody to know about Tennessee.
Oh, well. Yeah. Gosh. I know. We've done a lot of those Roswell podcasts. And
they don't know who we are. I know. I mean, they maybe know who you are just because you sound kind of the same.
Yeah, but, I didn't really change it.
Interestingly enough, that's my actual voice.
It's true.
Yeah, that's how I actually talk. This is just my, you know, kind of Minnesota, North Dakota accent that I put on for the podcast. Anyway, who are we?
Yeah, that's a good question. We're friends to this day.
Who still?
Play, yeah, we play. And the thing that brought us together, well, like the third thing that brought us together is we nice. Play Star Wars Galaxies.
Oh, we sure do.
Yeah, it's that game you buy in the store.
I brought you to Star Wars Galaxies.
No, we had to straighten this out every time. It's
what?
Like, I'm a big Star Wars nerd. It's not like I didn't know this game was out there.
Oh, you never knew.
I just didn't want to play because there are no spaceships,
please,
silly guy.
You didn't know.
Now, what you did do is you did subscribe a month or two before me.
Yes, I sure did.
Wow, like I couldn't subscribe.
No, you probably, obviously you couldn't.
Yeah, right. But what you did do is you said it was a whole bunch of fun. You tried to get me to join. And I'm like, blah, 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 well, blah, blah, whatever you have it, whatever you have it.
In your defense, you knew about the whole thing before I did.
I have notes going back 2 years before launch when
submit.
I'm just saying.
I'm just saying.
Okay. I'm confusing quotes.
You put them on.
handcuffs.
Oh, gosh.
But what's the one with, there's like a Lando, like, all right. Anyway, boy, are we off the charts here.
Well, you started it.
We're friends. Yeah.
I blame you.
I did nothing. I'm just kidding. I'm very argumentative today. If we have any scores to settle, we'll have to
right,
figure out a way.
Okay.
We are friends who play Star Wars Galaxies. We got to that part. Do people know we're friends?
Yes.
Yoda!
Oh, hi, Yoda. He's in the studio today with us.
Your friends!
And Helios! Hi, how you doing?
I'm great!
Oh,
Merry Christmas!
It's not Christmas anymore, Helios.
It is for me!
All right. Well, we'll get to that in just a minute, okay? Just go over there. There's some donuts over there.
Okay. Mm. donuts.
Yeah.
Oh, you all like donuts too.
Yes, he does.
Yeah. Look, hey, oh, look, he's got frosting all over his
stinker.
Face.
What a stinker.
He's got frosting all over his face.
See, those, they just
those
brought
powdered donuts. Yeah.
They just brought those donuts in, and I hate it when they get to them first. All we get are the cake donuts.
See, now I won't eat them.
Love the cake.
I won't eat them.
Why not?
Well, because they've been over there, and if there's a fresh box of donuts, I need to be the first person to eat out of them.
I just don't like them taking the good ones.
Well, to each their own.
Hmm.
I hate the most of the coconut coated ones. What's with that? All right. So anyway, we're Star Wars Galaxy's friends, stuff.
Can you do the disclaimer, sir, so we can talk about anything?
We have nothing to do with LucasArts, LucasFilms, or Sony Online Entertainment. All of our parodies and impersonations, which are poorly done, they're all for comedic effect only.
Yep.
If you don't like the show, then that's your problem.
I know. I
suggest you find a good counselor.
Yeah.
And you might want to find one anyway if you do like the show.
I mean, why listen to things you don't like?
Actually, you might want to find one if you do like the show more than if you didn't like the show.
I think we have some people, yeah. No, I mean, I on iTunes, I subscribed the other day to about 20 different podcasts. I just started clicking on them.
What?
Every time I go into iTunes now, it just endlessly downloads these things.
You've got a lot of podcasts.
I don't listen to any of them. I mean, that's the thing. I don't like and I don't listen to it.
Well, okay. If we commuted, maybe.
Yeah.
People that commute.
Yeah.
They've got that time to sit and listen to them.
Mm.
When am I going to listen to it? You know?
I don't understand the listeners that say they listen to it at work. I mean, I know a lot of people do, and that's great.
Yeah.
But can you focus when you're listening to something like that?
No.
As entertaining as we?
No. I don't know.
Okay, plug. We are at www.swigpodcast.com.
How do you spell that?
S as in Sam, WG podcast for the forums. That first one is where you can get the podcast.
You can get more episodes. Lots of
forums. Forums are www.yivvitsandmrbubble.com.
Yes, Mr. Bublio.
Yeah.
Not MrBublio.com, but...
Not my college teacher, Mr. Bublitz, but...
Which is...
It's really true. I just realized that the other day.
Mr. Bublitz, huh?
I took a sociology class from Mr. Bublitz.
That's...
Maybe that's just on the lower level. That just popped up when I was looking for an alt here.
That's interesting. I got to say, that is rather interesting.
I know.
Because you do have an alt.
In Vanguard, I have one that's Bublio.
Oh, in Vanguard.
Yeah, Vanguard.
Oh.
Oh, please. Yeah.
I don't play men in tights games.
I don't.
Oh, but you play Vanguard.
I play a woman in that one.
Oh. Well, okay, so men in fishnet stockings? That's your usual Saturday night. I'm sorry.
Oh, yeah. No. I didn't say
Anywho.
I never said I don't play those. I like to mock them. I can handle it.
Yes, you sure do.
I'm a big boy.
All right. Yes, that's true.
What's our phone number?
651-314-4357. Call and leave us a voicemail.
Yeah.
We'll maybe play it.
Maybe. Yeah.
And we do listen to them all.
Yes, that's true.
You can also send us an email if you've got any complaints we delete the complaints ones usually. But if you've got any complaints or any other stuff, or if you want to say, you guys are awesome, or you guys...
Right. Or PayPal us.
Exactly.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. That would be comments@yivvitsmrbubble.com.
That's right. So how have you been there, sir?
I'm good.
Mr. Wookiness.
Well, you know, this week has been really crappy. I mean, I have worked long hours, so I didn't really get to play
very
much.
Did they get a new fry machine?
Yeah. Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
And again, the fry machine.
We got a new clamshell grill.
What is that?
Well, I had a friend that used to work at McDonald's. I've never worked at McDonald's, all right? And I've never done fast food.
Uh-huh.
I have not.
Okay, all right.
All right, don't give me that crap, Mr.
Don't offend our listeners who do, though.
I'm not. I'm just saying that I haven't.
Okay.
So I don't know much about it, is what I'm saying.
You're saying, like, in a way, like,
No. Okay. God, okay. No. Right. Stop it.
We love fast food.
No, I mean, if it was, like, a librarian, I'd be like, I've never been a librarian.
Jedi librarian.
Oh, yeah. If it's not in the archives. It's not in the Dewey Decimal System.
Do her voice and say, Mr. Bubble, this book is 2 years overdue or
Mr.
something like that.
Mr. Bubble, this book is 2 years overdue.
Yeah, but it was a good book.
I'm sorry. You're going to have to pay for it now. Why did you have me do that?
I don't know. Just
you liked her or something?
No.
I mean, as long as you're thinking of her.
What?
I have no idea. What was I talking about?
I don't know. What? How? No, you were talking about...
Oh, I've been so busy.
Right.
I've been so busy. So I haven't really got to play much. And I've really been trying to do some mutation stuff on some beasts. And it's a kind of a... Mutating the beast with Yivvits.
By Yivvits, Yivvits.
By Yivvits, W. Wook.
Now, your last name is Yivvits also,
I have
right?
none.
It's Isn't just it Yivvits, Yivvits. Yivvits? Or you took no. you chopped that off to be more like humans?
It's just Yivvits. No, it always has been that.
But on Kashyyyk, it's Yivvits, Yivvits, right?
Oh, on Kashyyyk, you can't pronounce my name. It's very, very difficult.
I love it. The closest thing to your name is Yivvits.
Well, it's kind of like, you know, when like, okay, they have sometimes like foreign exchange students that come to the U.S.
All right.
They'll take another name temporarily.
Like Kenny.
Well, it just kind of came in. I mean, Chewbacca. I mean, maybe that, I mean, you never heard anybody on Kashyyyk in episode 3 say, Chewbacca, get over here.
All right, right, know? Right,
it's
right.
More like, who knows? I have no idea. He could be like, So I've been trying to do a little bit of the beast mutation stuff, and it takes time. And when you're working a lot, it's kind of difficult to do that because you get home and late, and you don't have much time to go and make your little enzyme component things and find all the.
Now you're talking
enzymes.
About dinner. Or you're talking about the game at this point.
Both.
Oh, okay.
So I've been kind of bummed because for like the last over two weeks, I haven't been able to work with any of my beasts. Do any leveling with my beasts.
You've had difficulties.
Yes, very much so. And I'm not talking about my cats. I'm talking about. The beasts in the game.
Oh.
And there's a bug where they don't attack properly, and it's affected both my beasts, and I can't level because they won't attack. They know about it, and it is being fixed. It's fixed. Went to test center last night.
Well, there you go.
It ticks me off that it takes 2 weeks to fix something that's that
basic
as far as like getting it fixed. It's like Q&A, all this. Whatever. Just fix it quicker. I don't know. Be quicker. More seductive. More dark side-like. Be Sith-like in your bug fixes.
They should be Moff Gergerod after right. Vader says the Emperor's stopping by.
Yeah, exactly. That. They're doubling their efforts,
man. Double our efforts.
But at least, at the very least, I had other things like to keep me busy, and I was trying to do beast mutations.
I gotta say, like in real life, you have been mega busy, because usually we have a MSN connection going during the day.
Yeah, I haven't been there.
We didn't get to chat much, brother.
I'm sorry.
I don't know what's going on in your life.
I don't know.
I'm disconnected from
the... I don't
know
where I am anymore.
The collective, the Borg collective.
That's right. Yeah, so that was...
I'm Yivvits of Borg.
Yeah, great.
I'm Larry Bubble.
Bublitz. I am Bublitz of Borg.
Professor Bublitz of Borg.
Wrong podcast again. That's Tuesday nights, all right?
Right.
Wednesday night is
Wednesday
night's Roswell.
Okay.
Tuesday night Star Trek.
Right.
Well, I've been trying to do the mutations, and it's getting frustrating a little bit because there's just not a lot to go on as far as what it is. So I kind of feel like I'm just shooting in the dark like everybody else.
I've been shooting in the dark so wrong. When something's not right, it's wrong. See, Bob Dylan, it just everything. He covers enzymes.
He's got enzymes covered. So they made it. I mean, there's got to be a key to this, like that, at least to figure out that we're using the right colors or whatever. We just got to figure it out somehow. And short of just experimenting with everything. So I'm hoping sooner or later we start to kind of figure this thing out, at least to figure out what colors.
Yeah.
And I know that there's a lot of randomness, and they are rare, and that's great. I think they should be, and it should be difficult. But finding this key is like, oh, man.
Okay, I mean, what about that, though? I mean, don't you want there to be some sort of mystery?
Well, yeah. I mean, the mystery is that it is very random. I mean, some people have tried to... There's a few that people know exactly what to use, and they may try 20 times and not get a mutation.
Okay.
And then they finally get one. The problem is, since it's that rare, how can you judge what colors are working? That means you really have to try each of these combinations 20 times or 30 times and hope you get it.
Yeah.
And I guess I'm not really complaining, but I'm just saying maybe we need another hint.
Okay, just to guess.
Just a
nudge.
We don't need a thing saying, well, here's what you do.
It's like the medallion hunt in the local newspaper or something.
That's right.
They don't start out by telling you where it is.
No, they say, I can see the bluffs from here. Or, you know, it's always first person sometimes, too.
I could be inside or I could be outside or whatever. Yeah.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Right. They don't start by saying.
They don't say, I'm on Main Street behind this signpost.
Is that GPS coordinates? I mean, some people would probably like it. It'd be easier if they could just...
Yeah. Helos, how would you prefer it?
They should tell me where it is.
Okay.
It would save time.
It would, wouldn't it?
I know. Yeah.
Yes. Well, even Yoda agrees with
Yoda
that.
Yoda could divine it through the Force, probably.
Yeah, but I don't think it should be easy. I think it should take us a long time to figure it out. I don't want to hand it to people. But it, you
but
know,
like the treasure medallion thing.
At this point,
if people are aimless, they got to give them a little nudge, another
that's
clue.
That's right. You can't wander aimlessly forever.
Right.
You have to have something.
Do you think they? Okay, this is because hearing you guys and hearing you and other people talk about it, I mean, do you think this was a case of excellent design and it turned out great, or they just got lucky? What do you think? And I'm not trying to take anything away, but it sounds like when you say something like this, this sounds like overly complex, that maybe just the way it all came together is like, wow, this is gonna be really hard. And then they're saying, oh, that's good. Let's keep it that way, because that'd be fun to figure out, rather than here's how we're gonna make it. Let's make it this hard and do this. And this
I'm gonna
and
this. Go again. I mean, I'm gonna go against the answer that people might think I'm gonna say, but I think that they really had the time this time to think it out.
Ooh.
They came up with some kind of a solution and said, you know, wow, that makes so much, you know,
George is brilliant.
No, I'm just saying, this is like from their side, you know, they're like, wow, that's amazing. We George can do this amazing. And they're, but it's so simple that once they get it, it'll be like, well, duh.
Rick McCallum. I was watching one of the episodes the other day. Rick, I swear to God, this is what he said. Rick McCallum, when George farts, it smells like baked bread. I mean, he thinks his farts smell like baked bread.
It's, right.
Anyway, go on. What were you saying?
I don't believe that.
What were you saying?
What the hell?
I was just saying. I don't want to.
I don't think it's. I mean, I know there's randomness involved, but as far as the actual figuring out the combinations you need,
I just had a revelation. I mean, I don't want to veer too far off the course here, but do you realize that, you know, Rick McCallum hangs around Lucas a lot?
Oh my God! No, why are you back on this?
No, I'll just be really quick. I just really quick, and then we'll get away from this. I won't come back.
All right.
He's smelled George Lucas's farts. There. Now go ahead. I'll just leave that out there. Don't edit that out. I'm just commenting for the record, because that's kind of interesting. Can you imagine the people that would pay to smell George Lucas's farts? All right, go ahead.
Yes, yes.
Yoda. Oh, no, Yoda's worked with Lucas on Empire Strikes Back, right?
Yes.
Yeah, and a younger version of yourself were in there.
Yes.
Yeah, right. But you were actually with him in Empire Strikes Back in that bit in Jedi, right?
Yes, yes.
Okay, and now Lucas, we know he's got dietary restrictions and this and that, right?
Yes.
Okay, did you ever catch him farting?
I don't want to know.
That's not a no. Okay. I don't want to dwell on this. I'm just. It's just.
Oh yeah, I think you do want to dwell on it.
It's just interesting that McCallum has smelled George Lucas's farts. Okay.
Oh,
Yoda, no, jeepers. You didn't have to fart, Yoda.
No, I don't think he was. No, he didn't. He was like, I think he enjoys the smell. He's like, Yoda, is that what it is?
Yes.
See, I knew it. Yeah.
What are you guys talking about?
Oh, nothing. It just Yoda and.
What smells so good?
what? Baked bread?
Yeah. No, that's.
Relief.
Relief. I fart.
Hey. Oh, hey, another guy's here today. Do you know?
What's going on?
Hey, Han, how you doing?
All right, kid.
Who are you again?
Han Solo.
Oh, okay. Mr. Solo.
What do you do?
I'm Captain of the Millennium Falcon.
Okay, that's awesome.
I'm Larry Bubble. I'm a pilot also.
All right, kid.
Great. I think he's kind of being condescending to you there a little bit.
I have a little sarcasm there.
I don't know what it is. Most people don't even know his stupid little ship anymore. They're like, stupid.
You've never heard of the Millennium Falcon?
No, we've heard of it.
Yeah,
but
it's like, I've heard of the Plymouth Volare, too. It's just not that great of a car. Come on.
All right, kid.
Let's ask Han about it. I mean, Han has been a lot of places.
Yeah,
and,
he has.
And
he worked with George Lucas.
He worked with George Lucas, too. Actually, Han Solo did.
Right, yeah.
He's probably been around him as well.
He looks a lot like Harrison Ford. I wonder if they ever gets
Have you been around in this situation before?
Kid, I've flown from one side of this galaxy to the other. I've seen a lot of strange stuff.
I've seen a lot of strange stuff.
Well, smelled maybe a lot of stuff. Hopefully, luck would have it that you're not in the room when he's got to do it, you know?
I call it luck.
Yeah, that's right. Exactly. That's right.
Bad luck, maybe.
Yoda would call it luck.
Yeah.
Oh, Yoda, you're crazy.
Yeah, he's just nuts.
What else have you been doing, Mr. Bubble? Well, let's just finish off that mutation thing. Let me just close that out and say that.
Can I finish?
May I?
Yes.
I think that they designed a good system. I don't think it was luck. I think they designed a good system.
They used their chance cube and look at what they came up with.
They designed it. I just think they did. They think they had the time and they did a good job.
I think it's brilliant. I think you just can't bear it.
We just need a hint.
A nudge. It's brilliant in the sense of all the in-game art that it utilized. I mean, come on. That's brilliant.
What have you been doing?
I have been playing the game like 4 hours a day every... No, I haven't.
Really?
I've just been in here and there. You know, just like you, kind of wrapped up in the summer thing. Summer's coming to an end. It's tomorrow, September 1st.
Wow. That's crazy.
I know. Where'd summer of 07 go? You know,
many of our podcast listeners will be going back to school, I'm sure.
Yeah, right. Many of them will be entering.
If not all of our podcast listeners.
Many of them will be entering junior high, maybe, or high school.
Yeah. That's wishful thinking, probably. But
right.
Or getting out of the institution.
Right. I wonder if they could listen to this in class. Maybe some kids are listening right now in class.
You shouldn't be listening in class.
Timmy, what are you listening to? Yivvits MrBubble.
Oh, well, that's okay.
Looks pretty good. Yep.
Looks pretty bad. All right. So what else?
I don't know. I was just in retrospect. I really had a good time. I spent that one day out there with you crazy people in Vegas, and that really was fun.
Which was the last episode. You can download that and listen to it.
Uh-huh.
Episode 80.5, which, by the way, people ask, it's because, why is it 80.5? Well, it's because we did an 80, and we didn't get it finished. We did an actual 80 episode 80, and it was before the Fan Fest, and it didn't happen, so
we've done that before, too. Yep.
They go into the archive, and
my favorite one is we recorded the whole episode when we were poopy with each other.
Poopy?
Yeah, that one.
Poopy?
we were mad at each other,
he's
whatever
got,
it was.
Like, some kind of poop
Yoda,
joke.
Oh, Yoda! God. Vanguard. We joked about Vanguard earlier. I have been playing this quite a bit, actually. I did because they had the server merch. It's happening this week for us. And it's an example of a possible future for Star Wars Galaxies. What they did.
I'm gonna. I'll just tell you what they did.
I'm not saying they would ever.
I know that. But when you say possible future, people, I think. That implies something, and I don't think it does.
No, of course. I'm just saying it's made by Sony, and it's a merge, a server merge, and Star Wars Galaxies is made by Sony, and they've always talked about merging, you know? And so if they were to merge, it's like one way they might do it, because there are like two ways to go, right? I mean, a server merge is what? You got 27 servers, 28, whatever, and you shut some of them down because there just aren't enough people. Isn't that pretty much what it is?
Well, yeah. I mean, there's different ways you can require people to move on to other existing servers.
I'm just saying. I mean, some people may have never heard of merges.
Oh, okay.
Because they're just not enough players to make the server interesting.
Right.
Yeah. Like any server we're not on, it's probably pretty boring.
Yeah, you know? I'm sure.
Yeah. And they're just like, crickets.
Especially Bria.
Tumbleweeds. Bria. Especially Loka. Our pals in Loka.
There's some nice people on Loka, too.
Yeah, you're so polite. Well, of course there are, but it's the cranky ones that... Yeah, you know, it's like at my retail store.
Our forums have gotten on I don't go to the Velsen forums much anymore because even they've just degenerated into this. I don't know. They're just not. They're just not. I don't know.
Okay.
Come to our forums.
That's the fear people have is that their server's going to be shut down. I'm not saying it would ever happen to Star Wars, but it's just people like at meetings and that. I remember people saying merge, whatever. Because the net result is it gives you more people because they combine them. And one way they do it is they just shut down the server and make the people start up on another server or transfer, give them a free transfer, all sorts of things. Vanguard, they shut down all the servers. I mean, they shut down all of them. They had like, I don't know, I'm just throwing out numbers here. Let's say they had 14. They shut them all down and they made four from that. And they said like, these three servers are going to go on this one. So it was new for everybody. It's an interesting way of doing it. So we now, there are three servers that now are one. And they spent a lot of time testing it. They had all these test things set up. They said, okay, there's a test copy in place for this server, so you could log in this server with your copied character. So they, all this testing stuff, test. And when it came, the day came, the first one they did, there were some little blips, but it took like 20 hours and it worked. It did exactly what they said. The one I was on was the next day. It was even quicker. I logged in. Everything worked.
Well, it's quick because there's nothing on them.
But everything was there. Everything looked right, and I went to some common areas, and there were like a lot of people.
Well, because they're all there.
Because it's merged,
So I don't know. I mean, I think they probably planned it, but it was just kind of probably lucky that it pulled off without anything.
I call it luck.
Yeah. See?
I agree. You and I are flip flopped in this one compared to the enzyme discussion.
Okay, look, here's the thing. All right.
All right.
People always
listen,
keep talking
everybody.
About
this. Now. Yeah.
From everything I've gathered, they said this at Fanfare and in the forums too. Star Wars Galaxies, everything is individual in that game. The resources on Bria don't exist on Velsen.
Yeah, I understand.
So if you're going to merge 300 people, do you just say, or, you know, whatever, you're going to merge servers, do you just say to the people, oh, no, all your resources are gone now? we already know that their resource system isn't such that they just can like spawn. Well, they can, I guess, but does that make sense? I mean, there's so many individual things.
I always hear resources as the reason that you can't do that. Yes, I
and the other thing is that they already know. Star Wars Galaxies people have been through enough, and I think that they just my impression that they even said this at fanfare is just that they know it would be an outcry of you know,
oh God, yeah,
of hate,
yeah,
and everything if people if they just said, okay, your server is going to be gone.
Well, here's the thing. I mean, Vanguard not even been out a year. I mean, people that play it love it. They want the game to survive. They know they need people. Now is the time. Is not the time when it's 4 calendar years into the game.
Well, no, you know what I mean? I'm just saying, yeah. I think people are always like, well, they're going to serve. I don't think they're going to do that, at least not anytime soon, because they do keep talking about that they want to offer free transfers, and they're working on it. But the problem that they're having to do, and I believe that, is that resource thing. Because in the past, when you've done it, when you pay for a transfer, you can't take that stuff with you. And they want people to be able to take that stuff with them. So I don't think that they're doing that like some secret conspiracy to merge servers.
No, no.
I think that people will naturally migrate to servers that are busier.
To ours, yeah.
To ours, of course. And then they'll close down Bria.
And Loka.
And Ahazi.
We love Bria.
And we'll just have Sunrunner and Velsen.
Intrepid?
There's so many servers.
I know.
That's the thing, though. At that point, once they get the population down, then if there's like 50 people on the server, you say, look, guys, there's 50 of you. We're going to have to move you. That's nothing that they've ever said. I'm just speculating that that's how you would do it if you're going to do it, is you let people merge themselves on their own.
Up until a cutoff date or something.
Up until some point. Yeah. But I just, hopefully we keep getting busier.
Yes, yes.
People on the forums say, oh, it's not getting busier. Oh, there's people leaving. I'm still...
A forum voice?
Yeah. I don't like it anymore. The game's not very fun. I don't understand why you guys don't have Jedi as an alpha class anymore.
I gotta go PvP. I'll be right back.
I'm so mad. Helios, do you still play Star Wars Galaxies?
What?
Do you still play Star Wars Galaxies?
Yes.
Are you a Jedi still?
I'm waiting at the village.
Oh, the village isn't there.
What? I'm waiting for it to change phases.
You must be an emulator.
I'm still eating my donut.
Oh, all right. Fine. Jeez. Well, that's my take on the whole thing. I don't like the wording you keep using. It's like, well, it's precedence. Well,
yeah.
I don't think it's server merges happen in lots of games.
Yeah, it wouldn't matter if Warcraft did one or if Auto Duel did one or Auto Assault or whatever.
Well, they just closed down. So, I mean, that's a little different.
The difference here is the franchise. I mean, the Sony thing. I mean, this is Sony. They look at internal reports and see how things go result.
We need to probably do our homework because maybe they have in other games like Planet Side or Matrix. Oh, I don't know.
You're probably right, yeah.
They maybe have before.
This one just happened to get a lot of publicity because it was a big deal. It was like, keep the game rolling. It's not even a first
year. So what server are you on now?
Cerodon.
Theradon.
I changed my business card. Did I tell you that?
Theradon?
I had to get new business cards. You put your servers in your business card?
I'm on Theradon.
Yeah, right in big letters.
Theradon?
Like that?
Yeah, look at that Imperial logo.
Read my card.
Pex would be very proud of you.
He better.
Mr. Bubble at something, something, something street.
Right.
And his email address, which you can send spam to, is this. And then his blog.
Well, you can say that one. Say that one. Tell the world my blog.
DeathStarSurvivors.com.
That's right.
I don't know what you're ever going to find there. He posts
Death Star Survivors.
Dirty pictures.
It has nothing to do with the podcast, though. I do not mention the podcast at all. So.
Oh, that's right, because you're in the closet.
Because I'm ashamed. Yeah, in the real world. The
podcast.
Yeah, yeah.
We wouldn't want his real friends to find out.
Pretty much.
We're like his other friends in high school, you know, and stuff.
Oh. Did you have difficulties in high school with friends? I was a big nerd. I mean, I remember, this is like an 8-bit computer days. 11th grade, my friends who were like in sports, they were with the ladies and all that stuff, and we were all jealous. But at our table, we were talking about the Commodore 64.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I had that versus Apple. I was an art nerd, so I had art friends I hung out with, and we talked about sculpture.
That's kind of cool, though.
Clay.
God. I was such a nerd.
You try that new clay. It's awesome. Ugh. It's like a cone four.
That's cool because there would be women in that nerd crowd, though, right?
Yeah.
See, believe me, at our table, there were no women.
Yeah.
At my lunch table, there were no. And I say women.
Oh, yeah.
Yoda. Yeah. So I'm making up for lost time.
So, anyway, your card says SWG server Velsen.
Yep.
Vanguard server Theridon.
Yeah, that's right. And it says Celestin organ donor.
Yeah, I am a Celestin organ donor.
No, just my jowls.
And on Vanguard, yeah, donate my jowls. In Vanguard, I'll donate other things because I'm a woman.
I'm a woman. Yeah. It's the only way to fly. I'm of that opinion.
It's the only way you roll.
In this in this male-dominated genre. Just because I get people that come up to me and give me money, and that does not happen on a male tune.
I call it luck.
I gotta agree with that.
Yeah, and I wasn't even hunting around for it. I was just talking to one gentleman about horses. And in Vanguard, level 10, you can get a horse. And I was just talking about it.
Man in tights game.
Yeah, I know. And, you know, frankly, the horse is just a speeder. That's all it is.
It's a horse.
It doesn't decay. It doesn't do it. Just it gets you somewhere faster.
Do you feed it? Do you have to pick up
after it? No. It just you can put on your toolbar, hit a button, it appears, and you're on. Just like a little. I might as well have my AB1 in Vanguard. I wish I or my jetpack.
Can I have a pony?
No, there's no ponies in Star Wars Galaxies.
But you said I want a pony.
No, you didn't win a pony.
I want one.
Oh, you want a pony? No, you can't have a pony.
I want to play Candyland too.
What?
God, he is just crazy.
Candyland? What do you mean?
Anyway, just let me wrap up the male-female thing.
Male-female.
Okay, it's the money thing. I mean, I'm not in it for the money, but I was just talking to somebody, and all of a sudden the trade window pops up. And yes, this happens to male tunes also, but there's just something there. I don't know
what it is. All right.
And also for quest help.
Well, that's the real trick, isn't it?
Yeah, get that quest help is pretty tough sometimes.
It is sometimes. Yeah, I played Lord of the Rings for a bit, and I was a dude in there at first, and it's just like, ugh. And then as soon as I turned it to a female tune, like, do you need help with the spiders, ma'am? That kind of stuff. This little, it's like, okay, dwarf, help me out with the kill these spiders.
Oh,
it's
God.
Like, anything else, ma'am, that I can help you with? God.
I call it luck.
So my recommendation to everybody is play a female tune. But then it wouldn't work, would it?
Mm.
Yoda wouldn't care. Yeah.
I still want a pony.
No, you can't.
Anyway, www.swigpodcast.com or www.yivvitsandmrbubble.com. 651-314-4357.
Okay, so today we've got some guests here. We've got, obviously, Han and Yoda's here.
Yes!
Helios is here.
Hi!
If you don't remember, our last Christmas episode, we had an inside peek at the Sony Online Entertainment Christmas party.
Right.
And where Smed was giving a gift to Helios, and the gift was supposed to be...
Diabetic needles?
No, that's what he got. It was supposed to be Candyland.
Right. Oh, that's right. Yeah, he hoped it was Candyland.
He did.
Yeah.
So today he's here. He's actually very happy. And if you can still go back and listen to that episode, by the way.
Yeah,
it's our Christmas... Christmas extravaganza number two.
Great. Those are really fun. Those ones we try.
Oh, we got music. We got everything.
Actually, we try to do them so they don't have anything that topical about the game.
Right,
so you
exactly.
Can listen to them anytime.
It's very much Star Wars and all sorts of fun.
So stay home from work tomorrow and just listen to our Christmas
show. Oh, yeah.
Shows.
Don't go to school. Don't go to work.
Nope. Blow off that final exam.
Yeah, exactly. He finally got... It isn't Candyland.
No, it's something much more complex.
But what else? What is this, Helios?
Candyland Bingo!
Oh, bingo!
Wait.
Well, really?
Candyland Bingo? Let me see this box. I'm not kidding. This is he brought
in. It is Candyland Bingo.
It's a color Helios, it's a color recognition game.
I know!
Okay, all right. Ages 3 to 6. Helios, yep. Are you between 3 and 6?
I'm 36.
Okay, 2 to 4 players. Yivvits, it says no reading required to play.
Oh, that's good. I don't read basics, so
that's good. Right. Yeah.
I can't read basics.
Okay, it's a real deal. What is it? We got cards.
We got cards. Well, yeah. I think we should. Yoda, do you want to play too?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, Yoda would love to play.
All right.
So we're gonna play a little bit of Candyland Bingo with Helios, Mr. Bubble, myself, and Yoda.
Yes. I'm gonna win a pony.
God, why is? Yeah.
I don't know. I guess a pony would be okay. If you had to win something.
So it's card. I'm seeing cards. They have colored dots in them. 4 by 4.
Yeah, they're little gingerbread guys on these.
Yeah, that's right.
Are they edible?
Wookie. You can tell me Wookie. You're a Wookie. There's a spinner.
No, they taste like cardboard.
There's it says green, blue, red, and yellow. And the spinner you spin, I guess it picks green, blue, red, or yellow. Yeah, you got that, Yoda? Yoda likes,
yes.
Yoda likes green. You are green, Yoda, right?
Yes.
That's like your home team advantage. Your home team.
Green. Yeah.
So, who's going first? Do you want to spin?
Okay, I'll spin. Oh, it's gone green. All right. So, I got green. You can only put one green down. Now.
I have 4 greens.
No, you can only put one down.
Okay.
And Yoda, do you have a green?
Yes.
You're all green, buddy. So Yoda's got one.
All right. Okay. So now Yoda's going to spin.
He's spinning with the force. Look at that, man.
Oh, wow. God, that's amazing.
That's so cool. He's such a trickster.
Oh, he got a good color.
Yellow. Tatooine. Yeah.
Helios, did you get a yellow?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, I have a new strategy now.
There's a strategy to this?
I'm going
to
go up and down.
Up. Oh. Okay.
All right.
Yes.
Yoda got a yellow as well.
I have a new strategy. My strategy is to get a red.
Well, it's your spin, so spin it.
That's my strategy, is I'm going to get a red.
Okay.
That sounds like a good strategy.
Yeah, that'd work.
All right. Oh, you did get a red.
That's a good strategy.
Wow.
Good job.
See? Well, yeah, you know, yeah, there's something to be said for that, I got to say.
Yeah, Helios.
Yoda, did you get a red?
No, Yoda.
Yoda. Yes, you did, you stupid Yoda.
He's just a trickster.
You got one. Jeez, Yoda. You spin now.
Is it mine?
MrBubble?
MrBubble? Okay. Sorry.
No, you can't use the force.
I got it all slobbery. Sorry about that.
Yeah.
Sometimes I slobber.
Well, green. That's something common then.
Green, Yoda, your favorite.
Oh, he's got a green. Oh, Yoda does not have one. I don't have one either this time.
What?
No!
Oh.
MrBubble has one.
Yeah, that's true. I guess
Helios,
I do.
Are you putting one down?
Yes, I have a new strategy.
No,
what?
I'm going to go diagonal and green.
Well, you shouldn't tell us your strategy.
Oh, right. That would reveal too much.
You know, I mean, well, I don't know.
Reveal too much.
We don't want to reveal too much.
We should play Battleship on here or something. That'd be super exciting.
Okay, all right. So I'll spin next again. Okay. So
use your wind. Blow on it.
My strategy was green.
Oh, red. I got a red one.
Are you close to winning?
Yeah, so is Yoda. Yoda's getting close.
What is Yoda need? What color does Yoda need?
Yoda needs a green or a blue. And I need a blue or a yellow.
Me too, I need a blue.
I need a blue too.
Well, if it's gonna be like a tie then if we all get blue. Yoda, go ahead and spin.
Yes, yes.
Oh my god, that force. I love that force trick he does. Oh my god.
Oh, good job.
So we all win, I guess, huh?
Okay. I win!
Well, we tied. We all
get ponies.
Well,
I don't know how that would work.
I don't know
if we all get ponies.
We could quarter it.
Oh.
Yoda, 1-2.
Yes!
Yoda, very good.
Well, that's cool. I mean, Candyland Bingo, that must be used actually for diplomacy all around the world, I would guess.
How long have you been training for this, Helios?
My whole life.
Oh.
Oh, my God. Wow.
That's amazing. I'm really happy.
George is amazing.
I'm really happy to hear that Smed finally got you the gift that you were supposed to get. And I hope you're still keeping those needles.
I might need it.
Yeah, that's true. You might need them someday. God, and
you still have a big box of diabetic needles?
Yes.
Well,
that's crazy.
Helios, I want to thank you for dropping by and bringing your bingo game with you. Do you use this for development choices ever? I mean, like if you have a dispute, like if you have a system you want to put in a game and, you know, somebody else on your team doesn't want to use it, do you resolve these through Candyland Bingo?
We used this when we made the NGE.
Oh, okay.
All right.
Yoda.
Yoda, we know from the past, is a dirty old man.
Mm.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. Did you go on a date last night again?
What did Han think of that bingo?
I call it luck.
Yeah.
Of course you would. That's all you can say, Han. Boy. That's all you ever say.
Yeah, I mean, how,
that's
Han,
the real trick, isn't it?
Yeah. Han, I'm going to ask you just point blank. This has always bugged me.
I'm Captain of the Millennium Falcon.
Yeah, I got that. I see that in the brochure you handed me, too.
Yeah.
In the card, your business card. It says Han Solo, Captain of the Millennium Falcon. How dumb are you? Because it's only like 20 years since all these Jedi were out there. You've never seen any evidence of the Force. Ben Kenobi is like probably hovering stuff right in front of you. You don't buy it.
Yeah, I've flown from one side of this galaxy to the other. I've seen a lot of strange stuff.
So you still don't buy it. You don't buy it.
All right, kid.
You do buy it.
All right. I think he just wants to shut up.
Yeah, and like, he knows he's...
What's going on?
Hey, I don't know. Well, Helios, we're going to say goodbye to you now. I think it's time to go.
Wait a minute.
What?
Here's how you tie your shoes.
Ugh,
look. What? Look.
I'm glad you're here to tell us these things.
Oh, okay. Jeez. Good. Wow. Cool.
Oh, man.
I kind of learned that.
Han, you're kind of crazy. I don't know. Yeah.
You are scruffy looking, though, Han.
You're scruffy looking.
Yeah. You're a scruffy looking dude.
Yeah.
All right, kid.
Okay, so finally, thanks, Helios. We appreciate you coming by.
Bye.
Yep. Don't forget your game.
What is this thing in the notes here about the Sizzling Summer Crawl 2007?
Oh, that sounds like fun. One of the Galactic Senators whose name is Lona Valamari. I hope I got that right. She is the, I believe it's a she, I'm sorry. You can't tell. I mean, you play a woman in a Men in Tights game, so it's, that's, I don't, right, know. Role play an event senator.
Oh, okay.
She wanted me to just kind of tell people about their latest adventure that this is, they've had these for a while, these cantina crawls.
Okay.
Essentially what it is, it's a lot of times it's a cross server event and it's for entertainers. They're kind of interesting. I haven't been to one myself, but they go from cantina to cantina. On August 19th, they had their Sizzling Summer Crawl 2007. It was hosted by the players of Sunrunner and Hollowood Galactic Studios. Hollowood, that's kind of funny.
Yeah, that's really good. Actually. I like that. Hollowood. Because like, yeah. In print, it looks hilarious. Yeah.
They're an entertainer guild.
Okay.
They focus on role play.
Mm.
Yoda, jeez.
Yoda.
Laugh it up, fuzzball.
This time, the event was done by players from Ahazi, Bria, Shimara, or Kimara, or however you pronounce that. Shimara. Yeah, Eclipse.
Chimichanga, I'm so hungry.
Flurry, Gorath, Naritus, and Starsider.
Starsider.
They all went to the Sunrunner server. So yeah, it's people good. That go to, you go to that server, I guess. I misspoke that earlier.
That's actually cool.
And it started with a small entertaining group that decided to cantina hop to different locations all over the planet. Huh. The event grew larger until Cantina Crawl 6, when Javier, I'm guessing it's Javier, not Javier,
okay,
made his first crawl video. That was the previous Cantina Crawls. Traditionally, most people who attend are entertainers. However, anyone is welcome to join in. Non-entertainers can do, of course, the dancing. They can play the basic horn and mm-hmm. the basic song and the basic dances.
Slither horn.
You thought that was funny, too. Thanks.
Hey, Yoda, there's role-playing involved.
Oh, jeez. Ow. Man.
I think that sounds fun.
So the cantina crawls are cool. So you gotta watch the entertainer forums and the roleplay forums to find out that stuff. But it's usually announced in quite a few places.
Well, they just fixed the RSS feeds, and I'm actually pulling my stuff in now.
They did fix
those.
Right
to my BlackBerry. I love that.
Thank you for fixing those.
Yeah, that is awesome.
We do appreciate that. Mm-hmm. I mean, there's still things to fix, but man, that helps a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Lona also wanted me to mention that somebody is going to be planning a event on Test Center Prime, TC Prime.
Hmm.
Called EndCon 2007.
That is awesome. You're kidding me.
Yeah. And so that's being planned by Eva, probably. E-E-V-A-A. She's from Bria. There's going to be other entertainers, and it's a new cross-server event, and it's going to be on TC Prime. It'll be at the Galactic Senate City, and they're still working on the details, so keep an eye on those entertainer forums. They're brainstorming right now. Maybe you can go in there and... you know, if you like to do entertainment and role play, maybe you've got some ideas.
That's interesting. That's really interesting.
Everyone's welcome again.
AntCon 2007. AntCon 2007.
So now going right. Coming soon. AntCon 2007 on TC Prime.
Oh, yo, he's so cute. He just snuggled up in my lap.
Oh,
Yoda, how are you?
Look at that. That's
oh, cute.
He's on my back now.
Oh, Yoda, you farted. Oh my God. Oh my God.
Yes!
Holy God! Yeah, get Gordy Yivvits. Go!
He doesn't. I told him to do that.
Yivvits, that is horrible.
I told him to do that.
Yes!
It's the root leaf.
Why did I pull his finger?
It was the root leaf.
Dude. I thought he was like, yeah, cool, yeah.
Star Wars Galaxies news. Chapter 7's coming along nicely, I hear.
Yeah.
They had some posts in the forums today. They're hoping that they'll get it on Test Center in about 3 weeks. They'll get Chapter 7. So that's the heroic encounters, the collection system, and a bunch of other little changes. Who knows? Lots of stuff.
And
lots
Chapter stuff. 7 leads us to Chapter 8.
And Chapter 8 leads to the dark side. Space.
Right.
Yeah, so...
Chapter 8 is where they're going to take out the space.
They are.
Oh.
Not funny. Space is, Chapter 8, but... They actually did get the Imperial theme park revamp on Test Center already, and they're going to push that a little earlier just to kind of like a little tide me over.
No, because I'm not trying to I'm going to phrase this in a way that makes it look like I know what it is.
I know what it is.
But I really don't know what the Imperial theme park is.
You know, sometimes I amaze even myself.
I mean, I got the Imperial logo on my business card. What is the Imperial theme park in the game? I'm a man of peace.
There's a theme park for each of the two factions. Right. And it's essentially where you go and you would talk to NPCs and they give you missions to do. You would get a reward at the end, you know, or rewards as you go.
Okay.
Or a badge or something.
Okay.
Yours is at the Emperor's Retreat on Naboo.
Oh, okay.
So
oh.
You would go there.
Oh. And where did I start off the party?
I believe you start there. You okay. go to the, and there's also, on the Rebels go to the Rebel base on Corellia.
Are they for every combat level?
No, it's high level.
Hmm.
After the NGE, they were just too easy. I mean, they were actually pretty easy even before the NGE.
Mm.
It comes down to more FedEx missions.
Okay.
I don't know how you can really make that any different other than try to make a story and into it. Story. Yeah. Yeah, the story's
maybe
great.
Some time with George Lucas.
Some time, well, depends on what he's been eating.
Yeah, fresh bread. McCallum, like, everything about George is perfect, Dan.
Oh, great.
They smell there we go fresh again. Bread. Okay, so, that's interesting.
Yeah, so that's out there, but it you can get some cool armor as a reward.
I was going to say, why do people do it? Armor!
It's armor. And even, like, Wookiees can, like, get, at least with the Rebel one, it's the same kind of armor we have now, but it's got, like, camouflage markings on it.
Oh, so it's something obviously different. That's kind of cool.
It's a different reward, and from what I've heard, you really need to have a group of people because it's that difficult.
Yeah.
So it's in the same locations, but I think they've just revamped the way that they work and the rewards involved. So it's actually something that you would want to do and not okay. something that's just like, oh, that hasn't been right for 10 years now. So
those battlefields or what are those?
Yeah, the battlefields, which have been removed 8 times. I think there's been like maybe in the history of the game, I've seen 3 or 4 times in patch notes that the borders for battle zones were going to be removed. And they're still there. I mean, not that that's a bad thing. I mean, it's kind of neat to see them there.
Right.
Yeah. So, what anyway?
I had a nice dance with Carmella. And
Carmella Soprano.
Yeah. It's just fun. Yeah, right.
So, she's great.
Yeah, it's just a classic bunch.
Avafia, was she there?
I don't think so.
Was CPAM there?
Is that how you pronounce it? No,
I don't know. CPAM or CPAM?
She's probably telling a story or something. She's a good storyteller.
She does do good stories at her
little parties. I got to say, at her last party, I mean, that's an interesting thing. Not the fun thing. No, but I played that other MMO. I played
MMO
there for a long time. THERE.
Oh, THERE. Yes, I remember you. I remember your days in there.
That's why I'm such a wuss in Swig. I'm positive is what it is. I mean, there's no kill. You gotta be kidding me. There's no killing in that game.
No, you make clothes and you can ride a hoverboard you can play cards.
No, yeah, you can play it. No,
it's a social MMO.
And man, do they have that down? I mean, it's just at times it felt just like high school was, relation.
Because everybody's picking on you.
The high school in my fantasies. Like,
Yeah,
where I actually was part of the crowd and actually had decisions.
Exactly,
my high school would be like, should we rent Back to the Future tonight? Or what do you want to rent? Should we get a Bernatello's frozen pizza? Or what do you want to get?
Yeah, I really like Bernatello's. It's great stuff.
Check out my cool digital watch.
Yoda loves Bernatello's.
Yes!
Oh man, I'm craving a Bernatello's frozen pizza.
I'm glad you're here to tell us these things.
Shut up, on you dork.
All right, kid.
Yeah, but you know what's fun about our parties?
Everything.
Us, right. No.
All the people are what's fun.
Yeah, of course. But this is the evolution of things. I mean, when I started the game, I just remember going up to people in the shuttle and starting to talk. And it's like, nobody's saying. You know, I've told the story many times. But that was there. It's like, everyone's chatting, in crowd,
out
crowd.
Well, it's mostly housewives.
Yeah.
Yoda!
Nice. High five, bro. Oh. Yeah. this is how much a noob I was. You got to picture, put yourself in the timeline, like when the space expansion came out, like October of 04. Just picture yourself. Yeah.
Back into your hot fall.
Right, because when you start playing the game as a total noob, like some elder or somebody will tell you like what professions to to pick, that kind of thing.
Right.
And I just had to be, I'm thinking it now, I probably was so atypical because up until then it was like all ground combat, this and that, and like what's the right combination? Because this is pre-CU.
When you had to actually think about your profession.
Well, it's just things that matter, all right? And I'm not like this much, but I had come from there. And the only thing I could think of, because it was really fun in there, I saw the tailor thing, right? Okay. This is like, they're saying, like, they're waiting for me to say, like, well, I need some bow stick or, you know, all of the fighting.
I need some comp armor.
Right. All that stuff. They're waiting for that. And then they'll help you find the right combo.
You're like, no, I need some fiberplast so I can make panels.
I didn't know that much. I just said, like, okay, see, there's a tailor. Can I, like, make t-shirts or something with that?
Can I make shoes?
I know. But I was very serious.
I thought, love shoes.
No, I did not use that voice. But I...
But yes, you did.
Shut up. Because at the time, I just thought it'd be really cool to make unique, because I didn't see in the game any unique objects of clothing. They're all the same old crap. And I see now why, because it's all cached on the client. Well, it's client based. I mean, that's why it's the performance is exactly. So much better than Second Life and There and those kind of games. That's the Achilles heel of those games is it's all server based. So if I make a t-shirt that says, you know, Yivvits rules.
I bet it caches that.
Well, of course. But you go in an area that you've never, you know.
Oh, that's true.
You know, they don't load every object to your computer.
I've never played Second Life, but I mean, just from pictures, the fact that you can use images wherever you want, it must just be a pain to load.
Right. And that's right. You go to an area and it takes, depending on things, it might take a long time.
Ugh.
And on SWG, of course, it pulls it from your hard drive. So you're already ready for it.
Anyway. Yeah.
I mean, that
it's there.
You spend your time for the update.
Not there, but I mean, it's there.
You know? It's like a Second Life. Not
Second Life, but it's there. Like there.
No, not there, but
yeah, exactly.
I'm glad you're here to tell us.
Yeah, well, sorry, I confused you.
Jeez.
All right, kid.
Oh boy, it's like the jelly beans in the Disney.
Okay, so what are we going on now? What is the point here? You came to the game. You thought it was
derailed.
The social aspect of the game.
Okay, to wrap up my thing. It brought me right back to the feelings I had in there, like some of the social things of parties in there. They had campfires a lot of times. And we've always
campfire talks.
We've always deployed campfires at our parties because they're fun. Yes. Like Two-Tone and some
of the
guys.
Two-Tone has to have a camp. Yeah, last time I didn't have one and poor Two-Tone was just circling. He didn't know what to do. You know, he's kind of pre-programmed like that. And I put one down and he was happy.
There, they had all these benches around them. And they have those, you know, you pick a dot on the bench and that's where your avatar sits on that.
Yes.
And it was fun. We were sitting around that and then someone started telling a story and that just took me right back to there. It wasn't fighting. It wasn't dancing. It wasn't, you know, this
and
that.
And people sat there too.
Sat there and listened. And it was a cute little
story. It doesn't have to be anything. I mean, you just have to sit there and enjoy being there with, not there.
There, yeah.
But
it's like a second life.
Yeah, but not second life.
Not second life. Boy, we're going to still wear that one out.
Yeah. Well, we haven't worn out the sound effects yet. I mean, please, Mr. Rubble, please. So we got the chapter thing coming up. They mentioned an interesting change to the hydrolase enzymes for Beastmasters.
Oh, really?
You harvest these from creatures, and then you refine them to make better enzymes. And they define how many points your pet has. And they're going to be making a change, so you're not going to have to try to hunt the highest level things in the game to get these good enzymes. They're going to be available from almost all creatures, it sounds like.
Huh. How does this affect Larry Bubble?
It'll be easier.
And Iskra.
It'll be... I don't know how it affects.
Can I make her a better present or something with
perhaps,
it?
Perhaps. Perhaps. You'll be able to get better enzymes without having to like go and hunt crate dragons for 2 hours. Anything else you got?
Oh, boy. Let's see.
Well, we're getting down there, Mr. Bubble. It's been a good episode.
Yeah, it's been fun.
We'll clean up very nicely. It'd be just like a nice Gundark.
Nothing to say on that, Han?
He looks strong enough to pull ears off a Gundark.
That's right.
Gundar, I guess. Sorry. Sorry about that.
All right, kid.
Who are you again?
Han Solo.
Yeah, what do you do?
I'm Captain of the Millennium Falcon.
Do you want to finish it off? Yeah, I've never heard of it.
You've never heard of the Millennium Falcon?
Hey, Yoda.
What's going on?
Yoda. I don't know.
Yoda.
Yes?
A lot of housewives played that there game.
Yeah. Oh, he's, I don't know.
He is so predictable.
He's an old, little old man. Dirty old man. Yeah. Yoda, do you enjoy reruns of Golden Girls?
Oh, my God. That's nasty. Oh.
Yes, yes.
Golden Girls.
That's crazy. That Rue McClanahan, she's...
Maybe.
She's pretty nice.
They're Yoda girls.
Yeah. Yoda girls.
The Yoda girls.
Good old Yoda. You gotta love that guy. He's awesome.
I do. He's a great mentor.
Well, you can get more of our show at www.swgpodcast.com. Or you can go to our forums and community site, blogs and pictures, www.yivvitsandmrbubble.com. Yep. You can also email us at comments@YivvitsMrBubble.com. If they want to leave us a voicemail message, Mr. Bubble, what would they do?
651-314-4357.
What else is going on this week, Mr. Bubble? You got anything coming up really interesting, really cool that you're going to
do? Well, this will...
Besides playing a little more in your Vanguard. No men in tights. No women in tights.
Women in leather. That's
okay. You can do that too, I guess. I'm going to do a little more beast crafting. I guess I'll keep trying with the mutation.
I'm out of here then.
Thanks to Helios. Thanks to Yoda. Thanks to Han. You keep beautiful, Yoda.
Yes.
All right. Thanks, Mr. Bubble.
Thank you, Yivvits.
Thanks, everyone.
Bye.